So that's how the East semis ended, and they can renew that rivalry a little bit more. The next chapter tonight. And guess who else we can see tonight? The woman we are joined by now, Beth Mowins, who is calling this game. Beth, Trae Young, he's been on an absolute tear. Five straight 30-point games. The Sixers defended him pretty well in their first meeting. But to you, what has been the most impressive part of Trae's streak, and how can the Sixers stop him?
Well, I think it's been a real sign of maturity for Trae. You know, when the first time these two faced each other, he was still frustrated with the way that the non-basketball moves, the new fouls were being called. He actually got teed up in that loss in Philadelphia, and it was his worst plus minus of the season. So the Sixers did a great job defensively disrupting him, and I think they were able to set the tone early, and that was when they were playing with a much better pace of play. I think that's going to be something too, that when they're feeling a little more confident on offense now, as opposed to what was the case last year, they need to feed off of their offense with a little improved defense.
Well, and on the other hand, right, the Sixers are still working to reintegrate Joel Embiid after he missed a stretch with COVID. Tyrese Maxey, he played really well without him, but what will be the key to readjusting to playing together?
Yeah, I think that pace has a lot to do with it. And I think Tyrese, obviously a natural two who has had to move over to the point. When you're telling him the first half of the season with so many guys out, hey, you be you and do your scoring and take care of your business, and that's going to be the best thing for the team. And now I think the adjustment probably for Tyrese and everyone else is trying to figure out, okay, where do we get our best shot since we're not going to have as many of them? And I think probably for Sixers fans, they're going to be keeping an eye much more on the field goal percentage and the three-point percentage as opposed to the total number of points for all the other guys around Joel as he works back to 100%.
Absolutely. And Beth, I'd be remiss to let you go without telling you how much I am looking forward to hearing you on the game. You're the first woman to call a play-by-play for an NBA game for ESPN. I think we can both remember watching television and noting the first and the onlys that looked like us when we were growing up. So for those young people, the young girls, the young usses that are watching you tonight, what do you want them to know?
You know, I hope they understand that the sky's the limit. You know, I had a dream. I always wanted to do this. And as a little girl, I surrounded myself with positive people who were going to help me along my journey. And just to understand that no dream is out of reach, and anything that you want to do, if you put the work in and you figure out your path along your career line, that you can do it too. And I've always been a huge sports fan, and have always been in a basketball household. So this is obviously a big night for myself, and to be able to work with Jeff and Cassidy and our entire crew is going to be great.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.